I'd be lying if I told you I didn't spend a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot of time on my phone. And I'm gonna do something that I've never done before, which is I am going to share with you today just how much screen time I spend per week on my phone. And I'm really nervous to do this because unlike a lot of people who share this amount of screen time, I've never even really seen what the normal or average is. So I don't know, I might be like crazy high compared to most of you. I might be crazy. It really surprised me, crazy low. But anyways, today I'm going to be sharing with you my screen time. And the reason I'm doing this is because today I really want to talk about productivity. And as someone who is a software engineer, who is a content creator, a tech YouTuber, trying to manage a social life and just like enjoy life, there's a lot going on. And I'm always on my phone. And I want to share with you today some ways that really help me stay productive and focused. This is very bright, but we're just heading into the co-working space, and then we're gonna sit down and catch up. Okay, I'm in the co-working space. It's a rare moment when it's like this quiet, so I'll do a little of the main floor, a little glimpse, a little tour, because it's really pretty. Okay. Also, thank you to Setapp for sponsoring this video. I am obsessed with Setapp. I love subscriptions where it's literally, you subscribe to it and you get this suite of beautiful applications included in it, whether it be for technical applications, whether it be productivity, whether it be workflow. Every app you can think of, I've always been able to find on Setapp. I'll put it up on screen here so you can learn more about it as well, and I'm linking it down below. But all the apps that we are going through today are on Setapp, and really all the apps that I use on my MacBook are through Setapp. It's amazing. You pay X amount per month and then in turn you get access to all the apps. So let's get into it. Okay, hi. I'm sitting down with you and Jack Nicholson behind me, of course. Jack, say hi.
Hello?
It's just crickets. Jack doesn't want to
say
hi.
What are you talking about?
I wanted to sit down with you and share with you some apps that I use to really customize my Mac and make it more productive in a sense, which makes me more productive because I am more focused, I can utilize my tools better. And I used to be someone who wouldn't customize my Mac or have apps specifically for different things. And then I started playing around with it and I got hooked because just like the amount of time you spend on your devices, whether it be your phone, your computer, similarly, I find that if you have tools that will help you make life easier, whether it be for focus or organization, you in turn will save a lot of time to be more productive. And this is something, I mean, time is the most valuable thing. I think it's even more valuable than money in the sense that we cannot get time back. We cannot get more time. Like what we are given, we have. And I always think about, well, how do I utilize that time in the best way possible? So I'm gonna put up on screen here. I have my computer here. I'm going to share with you my first one, which is called Bartender. And this is a really popular app, I would say. I've seen it on a lot of friends' computers as well. And I was kind of late to the game on it, but I was super excited when I finally got it. So Bartender, you can think of it as a menu organizer bar for Mac. It helps organize, search, and see your Mac menu bar icons while you are using your desktop or keeping it tidy, I should say. Okay, so as you can see, I have Bartender up on the screen here, and there are a lot of options to really customize it. So if you go to menu bar layout, you can see where you want to see the menu bar items, which ones will be hidden, different things like that you can really customize. And okay, so right now you can see I have very minimal things shown on my menu bar, which I really like, but I would want to add in my spotlight and what else? It already has the time. The battery would also be important, or is important, I should say. And I like that kind of next to, there we go. And then also to know if my VPN is on, which is very important to me. But yeah, the rest of them I'm fine to be hidden. And this is a great way just to see quickly. I found what was happening is I have so many different applications and these aren't even all of them. I just am not showing them all for this walkthrough, but basically I had so many and it just got very, it just started looking so cluttery and it really in turn makes your mind feel that way as well. So that is the first app I really want to share with you. Let's move on to another one. I feel like I'm sharing all my secrets here. Okay, so next up, let's do One Switch, which I will put up on screen here. And essentially, it allows you to create a personalized control center. So, and I find one thing that this app has done really well is it really kind of cleans up my Mac, and I guess my favorite part of it is the shortcuts. So as long as you can remember the shortcuts, that is key. Sometimes I make shortcuts for apps, and then I forget them. And then it's just a really big pain. But I'll show you what I did to customize mine here. But first, let me show you in Setapp. They have some really good images of it as well. One Switch, you can see here. Hi, desktop icons. This is another huge thing I absolutely love because, oh, am I gonna show you my desktop? We're getting really personal if I do that. Okay, I'm gonna show it to you, but it's gonna be quick, so you might have to pause this video, because it's gonna be, I'm just gonna show you for 1 second and hope that you don't actually see it. Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1. So bad, I told you. So bad. Okay, let's move on, next topic. Okay, so yes, One Switch is amazing, and clearly I need to utilize it more for hiding files. But let me show you, let me open mine up here. Okay, you can see here I have general, and then if you go into customize, so you can add, remove, or sort any of the switches on the dashboard. So I have quite a bit, as you can see, but here's what I was talking about with shortcuts. Go to shortcuts, so you can record a shortcut. So for me, mute microphone, that is something that I usually have. I took it out for now, but so say you want it to be, let's just do M for mute. Perfect, so you can see there's M for mute and keep awake. A lot of people like to keep their Mac awake for a long time. I'm not one of those people, but I'm curious to know the reasoning behind it. So if you are one of those people, let me know. Okay, let's move on to the third app. Okay, so some of you might know, well actually you all should know if you're watching this video, that I work from a co-working space sometimes, as I gave you a tour earlier. And I absolutely love getting out of the house, working in different cafes or going to co-working spaces. It really helps me get my focus back, especially when coding. But the downside I find to that is I just have one screen. I don't have my double monitors like in my office. And sometimes that can be really annoying as far as, especially if I'm coding, something on the front end side of things. So I have on screen here Slidepad, which has really helped me. So you can see it really helps reduce switching between screens. You can answer different applications like Slack without opening the actual app, which is pretty cool. So I'm in Setapp here, and let me just show you some demos they do for it. So it just slides over your current screen, which makes it honestly, if you are someone who works from one screen or if you're a digital nomad, you know this is like an absolute game changer. So I've been using Slidepad for a while now, especially when I'm out at co-working spaces, and it really, really helps me actually enjoy working more so, because I often would go to co-working spaces for like 1 hour and then be like, I need my two monitors, I'm going back home, and then drudge back home. So Slidepad. Okay, let's talk about one more app that I am kind of obsessed with. And once again, this is an app that I have through Setapp. It's actually where I find all of my apps. So this isn't unique to just productivity, but really for everything. And I'll put up on screen here, it's called SPOTLESS. And this is something, this is a tool that I've been using for quite a while now, because what it does is it will auto hide and clean up your files. And you can actually go as far to customize it that it does this on a daily, weekly, bi-weekly, however frequently you want basis, which is huge, because of course, as you are working on your computer and doing different things, more files are accumulating. So the fact that you can set it to based on how frequently you want it to be changing or organizing your computer for you is really huge. And I don't even know, let me see if I can find a stat quickly. Pause here. Okay, yeah, I literally on screen here, or on my computer, I just pulled up, do people focus better in a clean environment, or like, you know, am I just unique in that way? But no, there's been so many studies that show clutter actually affects your brain and how you work. And that's not just the environment you are in, your external environment, that includes your environment on your computer. If your Mac is a complete mess, yes, I know I have a very messy desktop, but that's very easily cured. If your Mac though is a complete mess, you don't know where your applications are, you aren't organized, that's going to in turn affect the way you work. There's no question in that. It's just science. It's just facts. Okay, but I really wanted to share with you some of the apps that I use, because I get asked often about that. What apps do you use to stay organized and productive? And I really have to be on top of that, because as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, being into software, being a software engineer, being a content creator, tech YouTuber, all of those things, they take a lot of time. And trying to grow your business, with growing your tech career, with growing you know, with maintaining a social life and all that, it is hard. It is a full-time 24/7 thing. So any apps I can use to make me make my day or make my week go smoother is key. So thank you, Setapp. I absolutely love all of your apps, and I always find another, like I'll pull up on screen here again, because there's so many more apps than I went through, and I always find one of my favorite things to do when I'm bored or just kind of like, you know, looking around is to go on and actually look at all the apps they have, because sometimes I'm like, hey, I didn't even know that existed, and this could really solve this problem of mine. So I linked them down below, so make sure to go check them out. Okay, let's move on though to something we've all been kind of waiting for, maybe, which is my screen time. And I wanted to tie this into this video because if we're going to be spending so much time on our screens, we might as well make it to some degree productive. And I'm not going to, I don't know, can you do it on your Mac? I'm sure you can, but for this one, I'm gonna show you on my phone because I'm always on my phone. So my screen time, my daily average. Are you ready? What do you think it is? Okay, here we go. Let me see. I'll put it up on screen, but this is for real, focus. I'll put a screenshot up. But it is 4 hours and 33 minutes per day. Is that a lot? Is that a little? I don't know. Let's see what the, can I see what the most is? Let's see. So the most is social, then creativity, then entertainment. So the most used, no surprise here, is TikTok. I love TikTok, it's so fun. Then I have Instagram, I have Splice, which is a video editing app I use, and then I have YouTube, Safari, and Camera. It's crazy though, it's so crazy how many times like you use your apps in a day or use different tools in a day, and it really makes you think of how much time we are losing in a day by just going on, especially social media. I'm curious to know though, if you are willing to admit and just be honest with me as well as I is with you, what is your daily average for screen time? When I searched it up, the average, like I just looked it up, the average is between 4 and 8 hours a day. So I think I'm on the low side, which is kind of surprising, but in all honesty, I spend most of my time on my computer, like a solid 8 hours a day, I would say. It sounds so crazy, but yeah. I mean, I work on it 8 hours a day, social on it, everything. It's crazy. Anyways, I hope you found this video very helpful going through some of my favorite apps that I use on my Mac to stay productive. If you have any other app suggestions, leave them down below, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.